Ozkizilcik in Ankara. In fact, let's bring up Omer because I want to put this point to him. Analyst in the security department of the SETA Foundation, the Turkish think tank from whom we've been having quite a few guests. Omer, thank you so much indeed for your time. You'll probably have heard these lines. Some of the Turkish towns along the Syrian border are under fire. Schools that are in that zone are going to be closed until Monday. The Turkish jets have been seen targeting areas which are about 30 kilometers from Turkey's border. So that's really exactly in the line of that 30 to 32 kilometers that Turkey wants to establish that safe zone. Just talk about that strategy on this, the first day and the first few hours of this operation by Turkey's military.
So actually, until now, what we have seen is that Turkey is going after the safe zone it wanted from the first day. So Turkey has been conducting an airstrike 30 kilometers south of the Turkish border to Ain Issa. And Ain Issa is really important here because it does not only mark the limit of the Turkish safe zone, but it is also the headquarter of the Syrian Democratic Force, which has been dominated by the YPG terrorist organization. So therefore, targeting Ain Issa is a clear message that Turkey is going to implement a wide and deep safe zone to facilitate the voluntary return of Syrian refugees back to Syria. And here, again, if you look at the areas which were bombarded by the Turkish Army Force, we can see two main things. First of all, Turkish Armed Force has not bombed inside the cities. They have bombed areas with no human population almost. And the areas bombarded by Turkey have not resulted in any kind of civilian casualties until now. So even for the NATO standards and even for the standards of the Turkish Armed Force, we see that there's a huge interest in preventing any humanitarian civilian casualties in this operation. And on the other side, we see that there isn't any kind of such understanding within the YPG, because today we have seen images and videos of YPG fighters in civilian clothes targeting from Syria towards the Turkish borders with mortar shells from within civilian populated areas, from within civilian homes. So we see that the YPG will use civilians as a human shield in order to prevent the Turkish military operation, in order to gain some political propaganda leverage against the Turkish government, against the Turkish and joint Syrian-Turkish military operation in northern Syria. And here again, the second point I would like to make is that we have talked about the depth of the operation, which is 30 kilometers, but here again, we can also speak about the area, which has been quite wide. So most analysts expect, including myself, that Turkey will start the operation from between Tal Abyad and Rasulayn, areas predominantly populated by Arabs. But the Turkish Air Force also strike targets of the YPG terrorist group east of Kamishli and near the Iraqi border, west of Kamishli. And this indicates that the Turkish Armed Force are really preparing for what for the Turkish safe zone, and that Turkey is going to establish a humanitarian safe zone to enable the voluntary return of Syrian refugees back to Syria.
Omer, can you talk to us about the possibility of what might happen to those Daesh prisoners that the YPG has been holding? Because in the past, the YPG has said that if they are attacked, they are going to release all the Daesh prisoners that they hold. The rest of the world is watching what's happening in northeastern Turkey, and a lot of people are thinking about the future of those Daesh prisoners. Donald Trump, of course, we know, has said to Turkey, if you encounter any of them, if you become responsible for them, make sure that you carry out your duties and make sure they don't get outside of your control. What do you think the YPG might do with those prisoners?
So actually, no one can foresee what the YPG will do, because this is a terrorist organization, and Turkey has warned that it's a big mistake to fight a terrorist organization with another terrorist organization. But here again, either the YPG is lying at the very moment, they are not telling the truth now, or they were not telling the truth in the past. Because in the past, the YPG and CENTCOM officials repeatedly underlined that the force who are responsible for Daesh prisoners are local recruits, local internal security force. So if they are local internal security force, local recruits, why should the, a prison in Deir Ezzor, sort of the safe zone of the sort of the attack, sort of the fighting, being affected by the fighting in north of northeastern Syria? So actually, we see that the CENTCOM officials has not telling the truth to the world, either now or in the past. And here I think we have to see that the ISIS prisons are mainly, almost all of them, are outside of the Turkish proposed safe zone. So if the US cannot prevent an ISIS breakout from the prisons with it, with the Arab elements within the Syrian Democratic Force, then Turkey is ready to take even care of them. And Turkey has repeatedly underlined that Turkey is not conducting this military operation against the YPG alone, but also against Daesh. And Turkey argues that if the current situation in Syria would go on, then the re-emergence of a resurgence of Daesh would be definite, because the local people hate the Marxist YPG terrorist group. And the, this hatred against the YPG terrorist group of the local people, of the local Arab tribes, is only a facilitator for ISIS, for Daesh to return back. And Turkey argues that only with local governance, for governance elected by the people themselves, will ensure that Daesh will not come back. And this is also the experience the international community has done, has made in Iraq. We see if the locals don't govern themselves, if they feel occupied as they feel now in Syria, then terrorist groups such as Daesh can exploit the situation and come back. And Turkey's actions now are the real guarantee for Daesh not to return back.
Okay. Omer Ozkizilcik from the SETA Foundation. Thank you, Omer.